percent. Hello, my fitness nerds. My name is Professor Wilpers, and today we'll be talking about the fat burning zone myth. So before we get started, just so you remember, again, it's Professor Wilpers. Now, the fat burning zone myth. The claim is that in order to burn fat, we need to be working out at lower intensities all the time. That's the only place that fat burning takes place. Well, I'm here to say partially true, partially false, and we're going to debunk that a little bit today. Now, before we get started, we're going to take a look at some of the background science going on, the background physiology, so that we can have an idea of why or why not this might be true. All right? So first off, I have a graph here, and this helps us explain what is contributing to our energy. Where is our energy coming from when we work out? And why do we think low intensity is where all the fat burning is happening? Typically, when we're training, we're burning a combination of fat and carbohydrates, okay? Now, here's an important graph. On the left, on the y-axis, you have contribution to total energy. On the x-axis, you have percent of max effort. Now, our lines, we have the fat line and we have the carb line, because carbs and fat contribute most of our energy when we're training. Now, as a percent of max effort, so obviously closer to zero, you're more aerobic. And as you get more towards 100% max effort, you're more anaerobic. So when we think of aerobic, what are some forms of aerobic activity? Say, for example, lower intensity walking, lower intensity jogging, okay? And if you're in my power zone classes, think zones 1, 2, 3, okay? Now, if you're used to heart rate zones, it's like zones 1 and 2, all right? Anaerobic is where we think about like our high intensity interval training, like our HIIT classes, our hitting hills runs and rides, that kind of thing, very high intensity type training sessions. So as you can see, as we go from a 0% effort to more of a max effort, you have less fat being burned and more carbs being burned. That's because carbs are easier for your body to grab and burn and create energy out of. And energy is in the form of what? ATP, okay? So this is a good reason why we think that we need to stay at these lower intensities, because we think that we're going to burn a higher percentage of fat total, which is true. You're burning a higher percentage of fat for the amount of energy that you're spending at lower intensities. And at, of course, higher intensities, you're burning less of a percentage of fat and more of a percentage of carbohydrate. Okay? So that is our graph.
Perhaps you can help me with a problem.
What's up, my fitness nerds? You still with me? Let's do this, all right? So now that we know when we're at a lower intensity, our body's burning a greater percentage of calories from fat than it is at carbohydrates, right? And when we're at a higher intensity, our body's burning a greater percentage of total calories from carbs than it is from fat. So we would think, again, that the fat burning myth is that it makes sense to work out at a lower intensity to burn more fat. That's the myth, right? So if we're trying to, say, lose weight and burn fat off our body, we want to stay at a lower intensity. Well, how is that a myth? Now, the National Academy of Sports Medicine defines weight loss as where you need to get a caloric deficit, right? So that means we need to look at how many calories are burnt during a session. So we have two different exercise types up here, low intensity and high intensity. Now, given the same amount of time, let's say this is a 30-minute workout, low intensity, high intensity. The total caloric expenditure for a high intensity session for 30 minutes, same amount of time, is of course going to be higher than a low intensity. Let's just say it's 500, right? 500 calories burnt in a 30-minute high intensity session versus 100 calories burned in a lower intensity session for the same amount of time. Remember, 60% at low intensity of total caloric burn is going to come from fat versus a high intensity, 40% of total caloric burn is going to come from fat at a higher intensity, right? We know this from that last graph we looked at. So When we multiply the percentages, right, the 40 times the 5, the 60 times the 100, you're going to get 60 total kcals burned from fat versus 200 kcals burned from fat at the higher intensity. So even though we have a higher percentage of total caloric burn coming from fat at a lower intensity, there's more calories burning burned from fat at a higher intensity, even though it's at a lower total percentage, right? Well, if we want to lose body fat and create a caloric deficit, we're going to get more calories burned from fat at a higher intensity. So does this mean that we should only train at high intensity? No, okay? Number one, high intensity means you need a lot more time to recover, okay? Also, low intensity is very important for helping us build our base level of fitness. Things like skill and balance, okay? So yes, we should spend some time at low intensity, but it also proves that high intensity training is helpful, and we have debunked our myth that we can only train at lower level intensities to burn that fat off our body. Homework. Complete. 1 60-minute PZE ride with Professor Wilpers. This is our low intensity, and we're gonna go for a longer period of time. Two, I want you to complete 1 30-minute PZ max with Professor Wilpers. All right, and this is gonna be our high intensity, and you're gonna feel the difference between both, all right? So, great job today. I look forward to seeing you at our next session. Remember, train hard, train smart, and always have fun. Get in there. Ah! Come on, my eyes are too thin. Hello!